Major funding for this program has been provided by Ghana Airways. Ghana
Airways. For almost 40 years, Ghana Airways has been linking West Africa to the rest of the world.
Your number one choice to West Africa.
Hello and welcome to Talk New York. Are you considering investing your money but not sure of how? Do you have all your money sitting in a savings account? Or are you an investor who is totally confused about the ups and downs of the stock market? And who isn't? Well, sit back and relax because today's show may answer most of your questions. I have in the studio two experts who are going to give us a crash course on investing. Joining me for discussion is Mr. Adusei, financial advisor for Morgan Stanley Dean Witter, and Mr. Nathan Blankson, life insurance agent for New York Life. Thanks for being here, gentlemen.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. First of all, let's talk a little bit about what is going on in the stock market. You're an investment advisor, so I guess that's something you deal with daily. The Fed cut the interest rate. What does that mean to a typical investor?
Well, it means that interest rates are going are lower right now than what it used to be. Mm-hmm. The Fed cut the federal funds rate by 25 basis points and also cut the discount rate by another 25 basis points. So the Fed funds rate right now, I believe, is 5%. And the discount rate is at 4.75. That is lower than what it used to be. That means there will be more money in the economy. The banks will be able to lend out more money. And hopefully the economy will straighten up and we have a good market.
What does that do to bonds?
It means bonds yields would also...
lower?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And... bond prices will be higher.
Okay.
So that's positive.
Okay. Well, you are a life insurance agent, and
yes.
Actually, I think you and I have had a brief conversation over the phone where you said, you know, people have a phobia of life insurance, that they think that once they take out life insurance, they're going to die. The way I saw it is that life insurance was a black hole. You put money in it, and you never get it till you die. Could you explain what life insurance really is?
Well, life insurance is something that many people are afraid of.
Mm-hmm.
The average person...
are they afraid of it or they don't understand it?
Either way, because they don't understand it, they are afraid to even broach the subject. When we talk to a person that needs life insurance, they say, no, they don't need life insurance. The reasoning is, well, if they have life insurance, that means they are near death. But that is far from the truth. Many people utilize life insurance in various ways. They can use life insurance to insure their homes. Their life, of course, is the primary thing. But what about their retirement? You can fund your retirement now, and then later on have a secure retirement. You are actually insuring your retirement money.
Okay.
So life insurance can be used in various ways. It's not only death make people rich of life insurance, or that's why it's necessary to have a life insurance now.
Okay. When you say you can use your life insurance to fund your retirement, what does that mean? Does it have a cash value? How do you give me a typical example?
Well, you put your money in the bank, yes, you earn interest on your money.
Mm-hmm.
That's true.
Right.
For instance, it takes about 18 for a typical 1 year old person. You put $100 in the bank every month for 18 years. You probably get a substantial amount of money at the end of the 18 years.
Right.
Okay. Provided you keep putting in the bank, you don't take anything out.
Right.
You gain any interest on interest. And you'll be gaining a lot of money or equity at the end of the 18 years.
Okay.
The insurance business is something like a forced saving. You name your price. You say, well, I want to save $250,000 at a certain time.
Okay.
Okay, so you work toward it.
Okay.
Okay.
So what does that mean? I mean, you in a sense, you describe how a savings plan works. I put my money in there, I'm paid a certain percentage at a certain point. I know I have this much in there. With the life insurance, what I'm trying to find out, is it liquid or is it only liquid when the person passes away?
No.
Okay.
Okay. Either way, when a person is insured mm-hmm. today,
mm-hmm.
okay, and mm-hmm. dies tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever they are insured for, that's what they are benefiting.
What if I don't die tomorrow and I'm still alive 20 years from now? Can I take my money out?
Yes.
And at what value?
Well, you have any life insurance, the company guarantees a certain amount of money.
Okay.
Okay, mm-hmm. It's guaranteed value, yes.
At a certain point
in the process of having your life insurance, so provided you pay your premiums,
okay,
mm-hmm. you are guaranteed that.
Okay,
so that at a certain time you can take out.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. But the dividends that accumulates sometimes are current, which is very, very heavy dividends. When the company makes money, you make money.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So that is not guaranteed. So you're starting to earn more.
But the value of the policy is what you earn if you get to the point based on the agreement that you have. Okay, let's talk a little bit about investing on the stock market, stocks, bonds, mutual funds, and whatnot. In our community, most people don't understand that. Yes, it's safe in a savings bank, but our savings account, I should say, but the stock market returns more over time. Okay, who is the best person to invest on the stock market?
Actually, mm-hmm. everybody who earns good income.
What is good income?
It depends, mm-hmm. actually.
Mm-hmm.
That's highly relative.
Mm-hmm.
But if they can afford it, okay. first,
mm-hmm.
I agree with the gentleman, they have to have some insurance.
Okay.
But beyond that, you know, on their savings, right now interest rates, like you said, they are very low
mm-hmm.
On savings.
Mm-hmm.
So if you can bear a little risk,
mm-hmm.
you can actually get a little better return on your money.
Okay. So when I say who is the best person, if you are earning $5 a month, $5 an hour, sorry, making about $200, $300 a month and can barely meet your bills, are you a candidate to invest on the stock market?
Right off the bat, I would say no.
Okay,
but again, that also depends whether that person is living at home, living with the parents, saving all that money.
Mm-hmm.
On a monthly basis,
okay.
The money that you save, how much return you could get on it.
So you
primarily
for you to even start, you have to have some surplus of cash that you can let go, that you don't have to touch for a period of time. That's what
long
you're saying.
Long term, yes.
For long term,
right.
Okay. Tell us what are some of the investment avenues out there?
Stocks,
mm-hmm.
bonds,
mm-hmm.
mutual funds.
Mm-hmm.
CDs,
mm-hmm.
money market.
Mm-hmm. Okay, in all of the things that you've listed,
right.
Who is best for what and what not? Give me some examples. Like if I have $2,000 to invest, what would you recommend as a financial advisor?
With $200?
$2,000.
Mm-hmm. Basically, mutual funds.
Mutual funds.
Right.
Why is mutual funds good? Will be good for me? Why do you think it will be good for me?
Again, depends on what the $2,000 can buy.
Okay.
Mutual funds are subdivided. You can buy units of it.
Mm-hmm.
It's like you're buying a unit of a pool,
mm-hmm.
Basket of securities,
mm-hmm.
and you have $2,000 worth of, you know, interest in that.
Mm-hmm.
So if the whole fund does well, you will do well with
so this is like a portfolio that you have other people in that group and you share,
yes.
whatever profit that,
yes.
you make,
right.
Okay, my question though is also that you are a financial advisor, so
yes.
I walk into your office,
right.
and I say, I have $2,000 sitting in my savings account. Mm-hmm. I don't have to use it for the next 2 years. Okay. I want to put it somewhere and see if I can make some money.
Right.
What is your advice? How do you go about advising me as to what to choose?
I will ask you for your investment objective, mm-hmm. what you really want to achieve with that $2,000, mm-hmm. and what your risk tolerance will be.
I want to make money. I want to double it.
How much money? You mm-hmm. want to double it?
I want to double it.
I would say stocks can really do that kind of work within a short period of time.
But and again, am the stock I a good selection. Candidate? Am I a good candidate with $2,000?
Of course, you could buy stocks with $2,000. Mm-hmm. But if that's all you have, I would not recommend that.
Okay. What would you recommend? I'm trying to get you to tell me, as somebody right. watching television right now, saying,
yes.
What does a financial advisor do?
Basically, what we do is to help people mm-hmm. get better. First, select media investment needs, mm-hmm. you know, to do the selection, mm-hmm. And also choose investment securities that they can utilize to meet those objectives.
Okay.
If it's income, if it's appreciation, if it's both.
Mm-hmm. So give me
or if they're speculative.
Example.
Sorry?
Give me a typical example. Of somebody,
portfolio? Yeah. Mm-hmm. If it's a large portfolio, mm-hmm. currently I would recommend at least about 70%. Most brokerage houses, that's what they recommend, around 70-75% into stocks, mm-hmm. 20% into bonds, and about 5-10% in cash.
Okay. All right. We're talking about investment in our community, and that is sort of like a foreign idea. We will work, get the money, put it in the bank, or keep it at home where you know your hand is on it. Why is it a good idea for people to invest?
Well, investment actually is something that people who look for something for the future do.
Mm-hmm.
Putting money under the pillow is a good idea. 100 years ago, the house can burn down, those currencies are gone.
Okay. Well, I put it in the bank.
It's put in the bank, mm-hmm. you stand a chance of earning interest on it.
Right.
As a vehicle of investment.
So why is that not enough?
You need money, you go there and take it.
Okay.
All right, you
right.
use it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
It's good. There's nothing wrong with putting money where you can reach it quickly.
Okay.
But what about your family?
Mm-hmm.
When you are no longer here, mm-hmm. what happens to the family? Do you care for them? Are your children be able to be educated? Those are the things that you think about, see. Because while you're here, they need you, okay? And it's hard. You might say, well, it's very difficult now. So think about, take yourself out of the picture. What will happen to them?
Okay.
Okay. That's where life insurance comes in, as a way of continuing income for the family,
okay.
you see. If a family member, like a husband, is no longer there, the wife should continue living. The bills do come. Children's education have to be taken care of, okay? And there are other expenses that they have to meet. She shouldn't fold because the husband dies. But the husband is the husband's responsibility or anybody's responsibility to provide for the next
future.
Generation.
Okay. You sent me a very nice package of women and investment that Dean Witter, Morgan Stanley and Dean Witter has put together. And they mentioned that when women are divorced, usually their income is cut at a very significant amount. Why is it important for there to be a special strategy for women, if you will?
As the brochure describes, it paints a clear picture of what happens when there are problems. And in life, there are a lot of problems.
Mm-hmm.
Again, managing money, investing wisely, is everybody's responsibility. Most women today actually do have a lot of money to invest, and they manage it wisely, and it shows the evidence.
Do women invest at the same level as men do?
I don't have the accurate statistics on that, but mm-hmm. I think at least the number of women investing today is growing.
Okay. Yes. Why was it necessary? Because what I'm trying to get at, why right. was it necessary to have a brochure that deals with women and investment? Is it because they're not totally up to par?
That particular brochure was for the education of women mm-hmm. and who are interested in investments.
Okay.
And the choices that they have.
Do you have a similar one for men?
Yes, we do have various brochures.
For men specifically?
I'll check on that.
Okay, so what are some of the needs that you see women going through? Like divorce was one of them. What are some of the reasons why women should be investors?
Well, from just looking around, I think usually most women who are not very active in the employment scene. They do not manage money at home sometimes. Mm-hmm. And when there's a death in the family or divorce, then they start to really find out means to actually keep things going. Investing what they have or what they will have in the future actually does make sense. They are allowed to invest. They have every right to, do well. Just like men do, mm-hmm. and the choices are there.
The choices are there for right. women. Okay, so for the community, the people who are listening, the African-American community, the African community, what is it about investment that you want to tell them, because you seem to be the criticism that I hear is that Africans don't invest. And for us, it's a foreign idea. We never used to invest from wherever we came from as immigrants. This is something that we are learning now. What is there to entice them, to tell them that, yes, put your money in here, save. Every time you turn on the television, for the past few months, the stock market has been going crazy with the Asian crisis and all that. So what do you tell the community to entice them or for them to know that investing is good?
Okay. I think for most Africans, most immigrants around here, they have a lot of pressures on their budgets. Mm-hmm. Pressures from home, pressures from here, the kids going to school, paying the rent, paying the mortgage. So usually it's very difficult for them to save money. The little that they save, I think, in most instances, they just leave it in CDs or money market or regular savings, mm-hmm. or even in some cases, just checking account. Mm-hmm. The savings part of it, there are a lot of means, a lot of ways that they can help themselves improve on the returns that they get on those savings.
Okay. How should someone start? Somebody listening to you right now who say, yeah, there are a lot of pressures. I do make some money. I work as a nurse's assistant or living or whatever, make $500 a week. Mm-hmm. I can save $200
right.
a month.
Right.
How do I start?
You start, first of all, you start by calling me. Mm-hmm. And I'll take the time to sit down with everybody that is interested mm-hmm. to show them the choices that are available to them, try to meet their own financial objectives. If it's reasonable, I think they can get involved in the market. The marketplace is very active. Of course, the market goes down, but then it also goes up. If you have good advice, somebody holding your hand through this, you do have the same chance to meet your own investment objectives.
Okay.
And have your savings grow.
Okay. Let's talk about life insurance. I'm assuming there are different type of life insurance there. Could you tell me what type of, what are some of the different kinds?
There are two basic ones.
Two, okay.
Whole life insurance mm-hmm. and term insurance.
Okay, could you?
Whole life is you pay the premium as long as you live.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the whole life accumulates equity,
okay.
accumulates for you.
Mm-hmm.
Term life is just like renting. You rent for a period of time, and then you know, when you leave, you don't get anything. It's just like renting.
I'm not sure I understand
okay.
that.
Okay, term life is you have a horizon. You say, well, I'm living in America for 5 years. I'll be living here. I'm going to school for 5 years.
Uh-huh.
Going back to maybe my country.
Mm-hmm.
But I need protection.
Okay.
See, so I just take 5 year term insurance.
Okay.
So if something happens to me, my family will have a certain amount of money to bury me.
Okay.
I send my body to Ghana okay. or to whatever,
wherever
it is.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Okay. And then they will continue living.
Okay.
Okay.
So I'll pay some money for the term life
yes.
insurance. Okay. Mm-hmm. For the 5 year period.
Right.
Okay. And then at the end of the 5 years, I don't die. And I go, you know, I'm ready to go.
That's
Do
it.
I get any money back?
You don't get any money back. That's why it's term. That's why it's just like renting a house. You see, rent, when you terminate your agreement, that's it. But whole life is different. You are building equity.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You're saying to yourself, I might live in America for the next 40 years when I retire.
Mm-hmm.
When I retire, maybe I want to supplement my Social Security. Okay, so at retirement age, that accumulated funds in your equity, in your cash value, in your whole life.
How is the equity accumulated? Is there a percentage that accrues, or is there a face value? Do you buy like $1 million policy, or is it?
Mm-hmm, yeah, you buy a policy that you can afford. Like many people buy, say, 250,000 whole life insurance,
and you get vested as you go along. So maybe the first 2 years you are 10% vested. Is that how it works?
No, that's you are insured.
Okay.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
You are insured.
But what I'm saying is that you're not insured for the entire $250,000.
Yes, when you are insured for the whole $250,000 if something happens to you.
Even within 2 years. Okay.
Even as soon as you are insured today, tomorrow something happens to you. You know, you are insured.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I mean.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. The equity part is what I was driving
at. Equity part grows mm-hmm. as you pay premiums.
Okay. So let's say I bought a whole term life insurance or whatever, whole life insurance.
Whole life
okay.
insurance.
And the face value is $250,000.
Okay. Yes.
And let's say I'm 45 years old.
Right.
And I pay for 10 years.
Okay.
And I don't die. And I said, okay, fine. You know, I've paid a premium of $100 for a month for the past 10 years. And I just feel like, I think I'm going to be here for another 40 years, and I don't really care about my children. I need my money to enjoy, so when I'm gone, I'm gone. What do I get? Do I get the entire face value of the policy, which is $250,000, or do I get an accrued percentage at that point?
The cash value mm-hmm. of what the premium you've paid.
Okay.
So when you are insured, you are given a guaranteed cash value. 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, or whatever.
Okay.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So at one point.
So it's spelled out in the
yes.
policy.
Yeah, it's spelled out in the policy. And you see what you are getting.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the guaranteed part of the insurance.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So mm-hmm. in 10 years' time, the guaranteed part is what you are, or in other words, you are terminating your insurance
and getting.
You're submitting it back there.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. We hear the stock market is down, is up, the S&P is this and whatnot. Explain those things to us. What is an S&P? What is a bull and a bear? And all those nice things that we hear.
Okay. The S&P stands for Standard & Poor's, and usually
what is
think you hear about the Standard & Poor's 500.
Mm-hmm. S&P 500 is an index.
Right.
What is it measuring?
It's a major average measuring about 500 stocks that are listed, traded.
Mm-hmm.
And the Dow Jones also is an index. It measures 30 industrial stocks.
Okay. And those 30 industrial stocks are so powerful enough to determine the entire economy as to the direction
they go?
Not quite.
They only give indication as to where the market is heading.
So what is the panic when those 30 companies or wherever they are do bad? Why is the whole world panicking?
Because, you know, the U.S. market Again, Dow Jones Industrial, for instance, is an indication of 30 industrial stocks traded on the New York Stock Exchange.
Right.
The New York Stock Exchange is a major market, you know, in the whole world.
Mm-hmm.
That's why they call New York the financial capital of the world. When New York is not doing so good,
it sets
the tone for the rest of the world.
Okay.
If the market is not doing good, you know, the Dow Jones, a bear market itself, it's not a one-day affair, you know. If the market goes down one day and then it goes up the next day, it has to be consistent to really show that it's bearish.
Where is the market going now?
That I'm afraid I cannot predict.
Well, for the past 2 days, it's done well. So
yes,
is Wall Street optimistic?
From what I read so far, some analysts feel, you know, the market has seen its bottom. So,
okay. Well, we almost running out of time, so I want you to tell me what you want the audience to hear.
Basically, I want everybody that can afford it, that has some savings, that wants better returns on their money,
Do you have to pay to consult with you?
No.
If somebody comes in to sit down with you and just go over their financial position right now, do they have to pay anything?
No, they don't. They don't have to pay anything.
Okay.
And I'll spend the time with them, and I'll be with them as long as they have an account with me.
So advice is free. When does it become costly? Or when do they have to pay?
Like if you open an account, an IRA account, there's only a $30 fee for it.
That's
and
it,
everybody
one time.
Needs an IRA. Most people do need an IRA.
Okay.
What is an
IRA?
Individual retirement account.
Okay.
If you open a cash management account, there's an $80 fee.
Is it one time? Okay.
Right.
Okay.
And you get a checkbook, you get money market interest rates on your money, and you also get a Visa card if you want, and you could write checks.
And also
invest in that same account.
Okay. All right. What are some of the other things out there for anybody listening? Would somebody with $5,000 should come and see you?
Yes, indeed.
Okay. All right. Mm-hmm.
Again, you know, the idea is to get a piece of America to own some stocks.
Okay.
And generally, stocks do well in a good market.
What about you? How's life insurance doing?
It's good. Okay. Life insurance has always been here. It has survived the Great Depression, and it has paid, you know, for college education, for families, for mortgages for many, many years. So life insurance is something that many people look to.
And you do assessment also? Okay. Well, we totally out of time. So if for somebody to reach you, if they want to talk to you and get free advice, what is your number?
516-391-3493.
Okay. And yours?
212-883-8158 or 800-995-4635, extension 8158.
And you heard it here, Morgan Stanley Dinwiddie, meeting with a financial advisor for financial advice is free, and also New York Life. So thank you very much, Nathan. Thanks, Alex, for being here. This is Yaa Ajimai, Okwampahofe. Thanks for watching. Major funding for this program has been provided by Ghana Airways. Ghana.
Ghana Airways. For almost 40 years, Ghana Airways has been linking West Africa to the rest of the world.
Your number one choice to West Africa.